So take us through these AEW ratings from Wednesday. Cinco de Mayo.
Yeah, I mean, when you throw in Cinco de Mayo, those numbers were fantastic because the cable, the top cable entertainment shows as a composite, as a group, were down 20.5% from two weeks ago. The last week was, they were actually down from last week as well. And last week was against the Biden speech. So this was bigger than that as far as a negative, which actually I thought it wouldn't be, but it was. So to do these kind of numbers when you've got that. Now, there were, you know, it was against no NBA games, so that did help. You know, they had baseball on ESPN, so the NBA, and the NBA is stronger than baseball. And, you know, that probably, like I said, that probably helps a little bit. But overall, the idea of doing a .42 on Cinco de Mayo, you know, and I think it's Cinco de Mayo after the vaccine, because previous Cinco de Mayos have been like 10%, and this is like 20%. So, you know, and I'm not surprised, you know, when if you think about it logically, that you would come to that conclusion that it's probably going to be more partying this year at Cinco de Mayo than any Cinco de Mayo ever, except for maybe ones that are on a Saturday night, you know, for a weekday night for sure. So, yeah, it's and you know. Well, I mean, I did quote 18 to 49 numbers. And, you know, AEW obviously is very strong in 18 to 49. You know, by percentage, stronger than any wrestling show, except for when Kenny Omega's on, what's it called? Impact. But aside from that, you know, it's way stronger than any other show, and then any wrestling show, and stronger than, you know, most sports. You know, occasionally you'll have like a big, big, well, not a big sport, because a big sports thing, you're going to draw so many people over 50. On a percentage basis, the only sports that are at the level of AEW when it comes to congregated in that age group is NBA and soccer. And usually they're below you know, like more games will be below AEW. Like as a composite, AEW will be ahead of both of them too. But there will be specific soccer games and specific NBA games that can beat it. So, you know, I mean, it should have taken a hit. It didn't take a hit because the attraction was so big. And, you know, look, it was a giant attraction, and we knew that going in. I mean, I knew the attraction was big. I just didn't know if it was enough to overcome the day. It did. You know, would it have been way bigger next week? But obviously, if when you look at now, I mean, they've got a timetable, and they got to get to the pay-per-view. And, you know, I think that they probably, I don't know the, you know, where everything's going, but I'm guessing that they need the week, you know, the extra week to get there, because they knew what day, that May 5th was Cinco de Mayo, and they knew what it was, and it was put there because that was the day. So there you go. It worked real, real well. It was actually super well. And they beat Raw, and this is the first time they were ever number one in history. The first time they were number one in a night. Even opening day, they were, I think, number two. And they've been number two a couple times. This is the first time they've ever been number one. And even more so, in males 35 to 49, it's the first time that they ever beat Raw or SmackDown. And they beat both of them. You know, so before they had beaten them in 18 to 34s, but they'd never in 35 to 49s, which is a tougher one because you know, that's where Raw and SmackDown previously were really strong and still are. It just was AEW had a really great night. And also SmackDown last week, because of going against the NFL draft, did have a very bad night. A normal SmackDown night would have beaten it. A normal Raw night, it was a normal Raw night. So a normal Raw night would have come close, but, and this did come close, but it didn't beat it. So, very, very strong in that regard. You know, as far as other stats, we'll probably know more, you know, as far as, you know, whatever else, you know, next week, probably. There was some other, what was the other aspect that they did really well? Oh, in the males 18 to 49, they did more than double everything else on cable. So, I think they were 0.58, and I believe the number two show was, 0.26, I think. Is that, yeah, 0.26. So, yeah, doubled, more than doubled everything. So that's, you know, it was great. It was great for them. You know, I mean, one of, you know, I mean, that's all you could say. It was an absolute home run. And, you know, what that means as far as long run, hey, a lot of people watch it. A lot of people watch the angle, you know, and where it goes from there. We shall see. This coming week, I doubt it's going to be that big because it's not as loaded. It's a loaded show, but it's not, I don't think it's going to do the same kind of numbers. We'll see. And it, and you know, it doesn't have to, you know, they, but
I think you could do 1.1 million.
I mean, I suppose they could. I mean, we'll see. I don't expect it.
I mean, if we presume that because of Cinco de Mayo, this would have done maybe 20% better than
20% in 1849. I don't know if it would have. I don't know how it would have. I don't know that in over 50, it cost anything. I know in 1849, it cost a lot. You know, over 50, I don't know that many people are partying because of Cinco de Mayo.
Well, would you say it was 1.2, 1.3 million had there not been a Cinco de Mayo?
There would have been a 20%. Yeah, I think it's real. I think it's real safe to say over 1.2 million. You know.
All right. So drop from there to 1.1 million for the show this week. I think that would be
it's
about
possible.
Where it would be.
It's possible.
I mean, I'm super excited for the card for this week's show. So
we'll see.
Moxley and Nagata for the IWGP US title.
Well, the one thing I saw is the ticket. I looked at the ticket sales yesterday. Nobody's buying tickets to this show Wednesday, unfortunately. I think everyone's waiting for the May 30th as the next big one. You know, when you get shows every freaking week, you know, or every other week, and in this case, it is every week because they're running the 5th and the 12th, and they're running the 28th and the 30th. So it's tough in the same building. You know, this could be, like, if you're going to skip a week, you know, if you're, you know what I mean? If you go, if, like, if you're in the city and you're going to go, maybe you'll go. But if you're a traveler, this is the week, you know, if, let's say you're a traveler from 3 hours away and you're going to go to a big show. You're going to Blood and Guts, right? You're going to go to the pay-per-view for sure. You're not going this coming Wednesday. You know, it's too many trips. So, yeah, this is going to be a tough one as far as ticket sales. 28th and 30th will be interesting because I'm sure they're going to do some sort of tie-in. They're doing the 28th. It's a Friday. That's a lot easier than a Wednesday as far as drawing. So they're doing the 28th for a 4 hour show. They're going to go start at 8 and they're going to run till midnight, because Dynamite's going to be 10 to midnight, and they're going to do, they're going to do Elevation in front of a live crowd, which I don't think they've done at all. So that's the 28th. And then the 29th, they're going to do a fan fest. So for travelers, you're going to be able to get, you know, a real weekend out of the thing. That's the plan. And it's Memorial Day weekend. So that helps too, as far as live. So I think that the very interesting one will be, can they fill the building up on Memorial Day Sunday for the pay-per-view? And, you know, I mean, we'll find out. You know, it's very difficult to sell tickets right now in that city. You know, so we'll see how they do.
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, WrestlingObserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them. The 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week. You can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts, and also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.